ओम जननीम शारदां देवीम रामकृष्णं जगद्गुरुं पादपद्मे तयोषित्वा प्रणमामि मुहुर्मुहुः। नमः श्री यतिराजाय विवेकानंद सूरये सच्चित् सुख स्वरूपाय स्वामिने तापहारिणे। माय रिस्पेक्टफुल प्रणाम्स टू द चेयरमैन ऑफ दिस सेशन रेवेड स्वामी सुहितान जी महाराज, रेवेड स्वामी गोलोकानंद जी महाराज, रेवेड स्वामी श्रीकांतानंद जी महाराज, स्वामी नित्य ज्ञानानंद जी महाराज, श्री अडवाणी जी, अदर रेवेड मॉन्क्स माताजीज एंड ऑल द रिप्रेजेंटेटिव्स ऑफ द वेरियस रामकृष्ण विवेकानंद भाव प्रचार परिषद्स हु हैव कम हियर, who are the torch bearers of the divine message of Ramakrishna, Vivekananda and Ma Sharda. As has been told and discussed earlier, that after the General Convention in 1982, the idea was mooted where the Bhav Prachar Parishads, which were formed to coordinate the activities or the work of the various non-affiliated centers. We know since then it has expanded horizontally at least. And as was mentioned just now, there are 25 Bhav Prachar Parishads with nearly 1,000 centers. Though the work has expanded from the horizontal point of view, I mean when I say horizontal, it means the increase in number of centers, the increase in activities, various service activities, and also the active members and devotees. Perhaps there is some balance which is required, and some kind of vertical growth also should be there to balance it, because both horizontal as well as vertical growth is required. Swamiji once mentioned that Sri Ramakrishna himself, his sadhana, his ideology is as vast as the sky, but it is also as deep as the ocean. They appear to be contradictory, but both have to exist side by side. So, as I was hearing the different aspects of the Bhav Prachar Parishad centers, non-affiliated centers, especially their problems, most of the problems had one thing at the base, that was there seems to be a lack of vertical growth. Internalizing or assimilating the ideas perhaps has not been given the importance it should have been. By internalizing, it doesn't mean that when we just try to do some kind of prachar, you know, it's just like a tip of the iceberg. There's a lot of thing to be discovered, and an in-depth study of the Ramakrishna Vivekananda literature, especially by the members of the Bhav Prachar Parishad, the convener and the other members. If their bhav is in order, that means the message has been understood and assimilated properly, and to one's capacity if it is practiced in the daily life, then it can inspire and become centers of inspiration, like our mutt and mission centers also, and draw an increasing number of masses, especially the youth, who will be the torch bearers of the future of the movement. First comes the bhava, and then we can think of prachar. Now in the morning I heard many of the delegates or the panelists were emphasizing that we should be thorough with all the source books. No doubt all the source books like Gospel, Leela Prasang, The Life of Holy Mother, Mayur Katha, Swamiji's life and his complete works, they are very essential. But apart from that, one humble suggestion I would like to make is there are a few books written later on by Revered Swami Gambhiranji Maharaj, The History of the Ramakrishna Movement, and recently The Story of the Ramakrishna Mission, Swami Vivekananda's Vision and Fulfillment, that will give us an idea not only of the inspiration behind this movement, but also the historical perspective, how this message which originated from Sri Ramakrishna was taken down and spread all over the world by his direct disciples, and through them, through the successive monks, senior monks of the order. So the historical perspective is very important, especially for the Bhav Prachar Parishad, when they can struggle with the different aspects of the ideology, how to put them into practice, how to make the youth can be attracted towards the movement. Then these struggles of our predecessors, the senior Swamijis of the order after the direct disciples, so many struggles, so many variety of socio-economic and political situations, and so many vicissitudes the mission has passed through. So that will be a good lesson for our Bhav Prachar Parishads, how to deal with the changing socio-economic scenario and the scenario. And then the third part of that book is the contribution of the Ramakrishna Math and Mission Centers, not only in India but all over the world. A lot of wonderful articles are there, which if we study can give us a hint or two as to how to apply the ideology, how to give practical shape to Sri Ramakrishna, the holy trios, ideas and ideals. And the last thing is the ideological perspective section of that book. I wish this book had been translated into different languages so that people from all over India come to know about the great movement, not only the inspiration but also the historical perspective, how the movement gathered strength, how the different centers in their own way, depending on the different circumstances, contributed, and finally how they can be applied to day-to-day life in different professions, which is the urgent need of the day. Because after the 150th birth anniversary celebrations, there were various service activities, various youth counseling activities, various seminars, and many Bhav Prachar centers were involved. And as instructed by revered General Secretary Maharaj, because of the time constraint, I'll just give a few examples how the Bhav Prachar Parishads and their members, with the help of the local community who were not exposed to Swamiji's, the Holy Trios message, can take this movement forward. Recently, after 2010, for example, the sustained graded value education program was introduced in many parts of the country. The Gujarat had the fortune to have 900 such units in about 400 schools, and 700 teachers were involved. We did not expect that it will have such an impact, because the coordinators, about 50 coordinators of our Bhav Prachar Parishad centers, when they approached these schools, a huge network was created, which is helping us when we take our route to those areas. So this network is slowly drawing these teachers to this Bhav Prachar activity, and almost 40,000 students were covered in almost 28 districts. So taking advantage of this, there is another initiative which we undertook for the primary students, because they are able to grasp the ideology very easily. They are responsive to the message of Thakur Ma Swamiji, and it can be given in a very easy way. So nearly 4 lakh students under the Swadhyayamala project, and that network, I am very glad to say that normally people feel that the government doesn't help in such initiatives, but it was the structure of the government itself, the district primary education officer of almost each district, the block resource coordinator under him. There is a wonderful network in place already. All we have to do, and everybody loves Swamiji. Swamiji came for everybody, whether they are devotees or associated with the Bhav Prachar or not. We found that there was such a tremendous response whenever our members went there. And these block resource coordinators, the cluster resource coordinators, under whom 20-30 principals are there, it was an existing network which was made use of, and nearly 4 lakh children and subsequently their families also were introduced to the life through a Swadhyayamala project, where a book of Swamiji's teachings, his ideology, and also a workbook, where they would be working in their homes without disturbing the present curriculum and the setup of the schools. You know, that is the objection which is mainly raised, that it disturbs our curriculum. But here we found, if the book is given and the book is taken home, the parents, the neighbors, the teachers all get involved, and the message can be spread easily. This is one more suggestion. Another humble suggestion is that for vertical growth, this is as far as horizontal growth is concerned. We try to spread the message and it reaches to many people. But then what after that? What about the follow-up which Rameshwar Maharaj just now mentioned? So we thought of another project is a Nivasi Shibir. Nivasi Shibir for youths. Because unless this message is given to them again and again, maybe if they stay for come on Friday evening, Saturday and Sunday, we have to give them sometimes when they come from certain rural areas, we also give them the fare. They come and stay in the ashrama, say 50 to 75 young boys, and then we see that that creates a great impact. They have to stay in the ashrama and see how the values or how the message has to be lived. So this direct contact, and as an extension of that, I'll just briefly mention there's another program which we have taken up where which is known as Vivekananda Service Corps, where the students are with us for almost 3 years now. They come only on Sunday. Most of the children are from the underprivileged sections of society. And once we tell them that poverty is not a curse, these youths normally, when they develop their self-esteem and a positive mindset through the positive ideas of Swamiji, you know, every Sunday they come. And this long contact has created a wonderful transformation. They also feel that they can do something. So we take care of their nutrition, we take care of their food. It's no doubt expensive, we have to collect some money for that. But once we do that, and once the children feel that we really want them to absorb these ideals of Swamiji and come up in life, then this training and instilling in this youth a spirit of seva through training, if they are trained to do seva through training in first aid, disaster management, basic rules of hygiene, and all these things, they empower the children, the youths who come to us, though they might come from underprivileged sections of society, to get a kind of self-esteem and self-confidence, a positive mindset which will help them to face all the struggles of life, the type of education which Swamiji wanted. So this is trying to build up the movement in a vertical way. The more contact we have with these youths, and the more youths come, because Swamiji knew that it is the youths who will take this message forward. And once we do that, and all the Bhavaprachar centers of Gujarat and nearby, they have all cooperated with us, and in the process they are attracting more and more youth. So there will be definitely be vertical growth. And one more request I would like to make, because many of the youths, they feel the need to do something higher and renounce the world. So especially the members of the Bhavaprachar Parishad who have been initiated, if they find any such youth wishing to join the organization, because there are so many private centers which are ready to be taken up, but because of shortage of manpower. So that is also a great service that will result in vertical growth. So I invoke the blessings of Thakur Ma Swamiji so that they give us enough strength and the understanding to take this movement forward. Thank you.